guts.
Hi. Hey. Hello. I know you. I mean, not you, the collective you. Whatever the collective is for a superhero.
I'm starting to think they're doing this on purpose. Lost satellite signal again. Word is we're not going to see any... another one of our friendly neighborhood Spider-Men? Welcome to the party. Dig in. There's enough cake for everyone.
It's not sarcasm. He isn't capable of sarcasm.
She's right. I'm Blake. This is my associate, Ms. Radcliffe. We represent an independent think tank, working with the CDC, troubleshooting agency, for particular kinds of trouble. Like Mount Vernon, Iowa last summer. You didn't hear about what happened there. That's my point. We're a long-term goal-oriented organization. Our role here is to maintain a scientific overview of the situation, not to intervene. And that's what we've been doing. Not intervening. Maintaining a scientific overview of the situation, despite continuing setbacks that someone with a high-risk skill set might be better aligned to deal with.
He means you. And I'm sure I didn't need to say that bit. Those things, those monsters, they're tearing up our perimeter. I mean actually tearing it up and carrying it off. This has the potential to be bad on so many levels.
On multiple levels.
A flight of superheroes? A fray?
We're done here. I haven't been entirely successful. Her rural upbringing leads to every community in peril tugging at her heartstrings. In our line of work, I find the best practice is to refer to small towns by case number. Yes, she gave me the same look. You really haven't been doing this long, have you? I doubt we'll meet again. But in the event we do, let me know how saving the world has turned out for you. I might have known your kind would show up sooner rather than later. The etheric wave activity on this island has been spiking off the charts. Oh, don't go all cow-eyed on me. You and I both know you're something of an occult hot potato. All that volatile energy buzzing around inside your skull. Isn't that why your quote-unquote secret society snapped you up? Soldiers are seldom selected for their winning diplomatic skills. It's all enough to make Ms. Radcliffe chew her nails. Neither of us wants that. Uneven nails are symptomatic of disorder. But I digress. In the big picture, our organizations are working to the same game plan, just from different angles. We choose to deal in hard, quantifiable science, and you're the liberal arts. To be candid, I envy your lack of accountability to the real world. Can you even begin to imagine detailing an event like this to the Joint Chiefs of Staff? I say detailing. I mean obfuscating. The government knows, of course, as much as they need to know. It's unavoidable when members of the so-called secret world decide to contact Dimension B in a Northridge mall, for instance. That was one hell of a spring. Life is just full of inconvenient surprises, and I'm not big on surprises. It's what attracted me to this line of work. The chance to normalize the curve. No offense, there'll always be a place for statistical outliers like yourself. The average American doesn't need to see the whole carnival, but they've always loved the sideshow. I couldn't comment on rumor or speculation over the group's activities. One, Ms. Radcliffe and I only represent a subsidiary. Two, I have undergone considerable media training. What I can discuss is that there's no side agenda, no conspiracy. That sort of sensationalism is more your controller's style. Our deployment was standard operating procedure in the event of an occult emergency. Ideally, we could have isolated and contained without anyone registering that we were here, provided that they overlooked the primary blockades, the corporate security detail, the air support. Not my call, for the record. The priority is now for us to work together, but separately, towards a satisfactory conclusion for all parties. Finger-pointing will get us nowhere at this advanced stage of contagion. You shouldn't confuse a team leader with a team player. I would have preferred to oversee this operation remotely, on time, under budget, with minimum deployment of heavy weapons. However, I had Miss Radcliffe to consider. A promising graduate, but easily distracted by human elements. My intention was to keep her focused on our corporation's core values.
Stubborn enough to remind me of my pop. He just couldn't accept that genetics was a tool, not an intrinsic sin. We'd argue it out on the porch every night. Me trying to convince him the world wasn't black and white. Right and wrong, God's will or not, while mosquitoes bit chunks out of us. I told him it wasn't that simple. But now, I think maybe it is that simple.
You have my professional sympathy, Radcliffe. But I can't spare the bandwidth right now to manage your down-home Judeo-Christian guilt. I was never much one for multitasking. A few hundred die, billions are saved. Those are the absolutes we're dealing with. Unfortunately, Kingsmith came up against the sharp edge of evolution. So it goes. I'm familiar with that expression. It means the progress versus time graph for this operation is about to stop making us look good.
It's these abnormally deformed condition 17s. Can we just start calling them zombies, sir? The autopsy shows muscle mass still expanding. New neural activity. I'm trying to isolate the chemical reactions, but in a soundbite. Zombies on PCP.
Humor me for the sake of our field report. The condition... The zombies. They are slabs of dead tissue. Ambulatory. Cannibalistic. But dead. Inert. What's the stimulus?
My guess? An environmental trigger. See how they've been concentrated around this northern island? We need to contain this mutation. We need to get out there and...
Absolutely no field trips, Radcliffe. Safety first. We're just the science detail, and we're already closer than optimal survival distance to the occult epicenter on this one. Leave that to the red shirts.
Did you just drop a Star Trek reference, sir?
Whatever gave you that idea?
I know what you must be thinking. How'd she end up here? Well, I am a sucker for field uniforms with silver lining. No, that's a joke. I was always the bugs and animals girl at school, so this is, kind of a career path. Cryptozoology? I guess I didn't see that coming when I signed up for R&D. They don't really ease you into it gently. How all the urban legends aren't legends, or even that urban. I mean, the stuff I saw in Iowa would... Never mind. Well, I don't have any regrets. Yet. And this work gives great miles. Even more now that we're getting flown to some new catastrophe every couple of months. Well, you must be pretty used to it by now, though, right? Doing that thing you do. Would you say a flock of superheroes? This is totally bugging me. It's nice to be able to talk to someone about all this. Who understands? I can't call up my folks and be all, you will never believe what I performed Frozen Section on today. I see these things so they'll never have to. I'm keeping them safe. Safe in their reality. Protecting the world with science. I was so into that idea as a kid. Now, well, I think it can make you a little crazy. Staring too long into the abyss and all. Down the old electron microscope. Like, I was happy to be one of the Valley Girls. We have an internal mailing list. But now they're calling us the Frankenstein Patrol. Things are getting kinda gross. But I have Blake as a grounding influence. Oh, he is super grounded. And so I look at him and think, Anne, honey, just do what you're told and then get your buns out of there. I'm under a strict NDA. I can't really talk about my employer or my job or Blake or all this hardware or the helicopters or... Oops, that was already too much. Can I retract? Look, it's not like you can't figure out things on your own. Put two and two together. We're here and I'm sure you've seen our base camp out west. Ugh, shoot, damn it. Nice one, Anne. I guess covert operation means be a blabbermouth in your world. Sorry. Yes, we work for the Orochi Group. No, we can't talk about our reasons for being here, but look around. Isn't it painfully obvious? I'd love to be part of an ancient secret society. I'm sure you guys have access to some amazing stuff, like libraries and artifacts and... Okay, yeah, I'm geeking out a bit. But come on, I grew up reading about this stuff. It's like all my childhood fantasies suddenly coming true. Superheroes, secret societies, creepy crawlies, magic. If my mom only knew, she would feel so bad about trying to get me to be normal. My mom doesn't know anything at all. Want to go another round of confirm or deny while the centrifuge spins up?
Do I have a choice?
Confirm or deny. You are an overachiever since your parents named you after a more famous Harrison.
Strongly deny. Confirm or deny. You ordered one of those I'm a Valley Girl sweatshirts from the company store.
One in pink and one in oatmeal. I mean, confirm. Confirm or deny. You play a mean tenor sax.
You'd only know that if you read my profiling, Radcliffe.
Are you asking me to confirm or deny if I specifically requested to be assigned to you?
Never crossed my mind, Anne. Important call. Have to make it. I know it's not pretty out there, but you don't always get a chance to call it when your coin is in the air. Our business is increasing the statistical average for the next toss. That's adaptive science.
Mr. Blake isn't really a people person, and the people of Kingsmith need that satellite line so badly. Sometimes the greater good doesn't feel very good at all. I don't exactly make the need-to-know level for what's really going on, aside from the obvious. But I do need to know. The group has helicopters flying most nights. Black helicopters, I'm not even kidding. Somewhere out at the airport. Obviously, this is all highly confidential information. Far too confidential for me to have overheard. But I'd rather you find out this way before I'm in deep enough to be told. While I can still make like a church-going girl with a clear conscience. Not that Blake will let me visit the church here. Off-limits, like the rest of town.
You know the ground rules of an occult outbreak. Quarantine, quarantine.
Quarantine.
Did I miss something?